Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about exploratory data analysis. So this is the popular first step that we need to do, and it is normally called EDA. So for EDA, it is the chapter 7 of the book, and you can find it here. You want to generate questions about your data, and you want to search for answers by visualizing, transforming, and modeling your data. And you also want to use what you learn to refine your questions and generate new questions. So this is a very important step that you are getting to know the data. And in this chapter, I'm thinking maybe I can make videos on variation, which is mainly about the distributions of a dataset, a variable, a subset of a variable, and then we can talk about distributions or correlations and associations of two variables. Like it can be a continuous variable with a categorical variable. Or you also want to know the patterns of maybe two continuous random variables. So we are going to work on all of these, and I hope you can get the most of it. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, now I have RStudio opened. So let's create a new R script. And what I'm going to type here is to talk about the variation of EDA. So we are going to work on variation for this video. And we know each variable has its own pattern of variation. So the best way to understand that pattern is to visualize the distribution of the variable's values. So, as you may know, there are actually two types of variables. One is categorical variable and one is numerical variable. So, we are going to talk about the variations based on like different types of variable. How you are going to visualize your data based on the type of the variables. So let's first look at categorical data. So categorical data is like gender, male, female, class year, like the class of 2021, 22, 23, 24, right? And there can be like education level, like high school, middle school, college, and so on. So those things that you can describe using several categories are named as categorical variables. And for categorical variables, a bar chart is often used, a bar chart. So the first of all, let's load the package ggplot2. If you have never used this package, make sure you want to type install.packages and within the quotation mark type ggplot2 and run that line before you run line 9. So because I have installed my package, I just run library function to load that package. And the data we are going to use for illustration is called diamonds. And you can run that line so that you have diamonds data here. You can even look at the data by double clicking the diamonds data on the right side. So you can see for this data, we actually have many observations with 10 variables. We have carat, cut, color, clarity, and so on. So those are the variables within the data set. So let's also talk about the methods using some questions. I'm still going to type on the R script section. So I'm going to name it as Q1. And I want to know how does the cut of the variables distributed in the diamonds data, because you can have different diamonds data, right? The data set we are using here is the diamonds data within the ggplot2 package. So I want to know, how does the cut of the variables distributed in the diamonds data? Like, how does the cut variable distribute it from this data set we are looking at? And because looking at cut here, you can see there are ideal, premium, good, very good, fair, and so on. So that is a categorical variable. So what we are going to do is to create a bar chart. So we can type ggplot. So ggplot is the function we are using. And we can specify data equals diamonds. And then we can specify the aesthetic information by letting x equals cut. And then we add a plus sign and we specify our geometric object. We use the bar chart. So we can just do it like this. And we can run these two lines and we are getting a bar chart on the right side. You can zoom the graph and you can see the bar chart looks very nice. We have the number of observations for different cuts. We can see we have ideal the most. And we have fair cut the least number of observations. And if you want, you can also change the name of the graph to make it more professional, or actually change the name of the graph by adding another line. And I'm using the BW, black, white, and you can see the picture is changed into this way. And which way you like, you may want to have a consistent graph in your either your report or your paper. So now maybe we can work on numerical variable. And my question here is that, how does the price distribute in the diamonds data? The price is actually the cut and the price of the diamonds. So because for numerical variable, very often people would use a histogram to check on the distribution. And right now we can just draw a histogram. So same thing, you want to specify the data set. You can just get rid of the data equals, because the first thing you type there should be the name of the data set. And then you specify the aesthetic information. It is just the price, because we are only looking at the distribution of the price. Make sure you close all the parentheses you wrote there. And then you can do GOM histogram, and that's it. So you may want to use the same theme for different graphs you have. So I add the theme again. So you can see the histogram looks a little weird, because it's like so many bars, which means you have created so many ranges within the histogram. And you can see there is a warning here. It said bins equals 30 may make the graph look better, right? So one thing you can do is to change the number of bars within the GOM histogram. I often use about 15. So you can try different numbers and see how it can change the histogram. So it looks like this. We are actually using wider bars now. And move further, we can dive deeper by asking a follow-up question. How does the price distribute differently for different cut? Right, we looked at the price, but it is actually meaningless if you only look at the price without thinking about the cut or the carrot. So how does price distribute differently for different cut? And we can try to do that together here by typing ggplot dataset still we have price, and then we can specify group equals cut, which means we are actually talking about the price according to different cut. And again, we are doing histogram. And what we can do here is we can specify the bins equals 10 maybe this time. And then we can add a facet. Like it is like we want to look at the distributions of the price according to different cut group. So adding that facet is actually making it possible to split the histograms according to the cut. So we can use this thing there, and we can also specify the number of rows. Like when you draw the graph, you want to specify how you are going to draw it, right? Are you going to lay out the small pictures in one line, or you want to have like 2x2? So you want to specify that this display here by setting up the n row equals 1, 2, 3, or based on how many categories you have. So this is the graph. We are actually drawing one histogram for each cut. And you can see we have 5 cutting groups. So that's why we have 5 small pictures in this graph. The fourth question I'm asking here is that I want you to try to understand how we can combine the two packages. One is dplyr, one is ggplot. Both packages are within tidyverse. How can we combine them together? Like we do manipulation, we visualize them within one step. So the question I'm using here is for the diamonds with less than 1 carat, how does price distribute? Like what's the distribution for the price when the diamonds are less than 1 carat? So the thing we are going to do is we need to manipulate our data because we are actually creating a subset from the diamonds data. We are not using the full data set now. So I actually loaded the package dplyr. If you have not used it before, you need to type install.packages and then type dplyr within the double quotation mark. So I'm going to add some pipeline work. So I'm going to do the first pipe is to filter the full diamonds data according to carat, and I let it smaller than 1. And then I'm adding my second pipe, which is for drawing the graph. So I'm using ggplot. I can use a dot here because we actually manipulated our data and this is a follow-up step. So you can use a dot here, which is the diamonds with less than 1 carat. So then you can still specify the same thing, x equals price, and then you can add. So after that, you want to use a plus sign because in ggplot, you want to use a plus sign to add layers to the graph. So same thing. It is like this. And then now you can try a different theme. Maybe you can try the classic one. And let's run this graph here and see what we are getting. It's very quick. So you can see this is the classic theme. It's so clean and so neat. And you can definitely set up more questions, like if you want to look deeper of the data set. So maybe you want to add more restrictions. So for the diamonds with less than 1 carat. Cut being gold. Like you want to specify the carat, the cut, and then look at the distribution of the cut. The price, sorry. So we have two conditions here. And you can try to do it by yourself by pause the video here, or you can just follow me. Add the pipe. So what we are doing is add the filter function. So same thing for the caret. But now what we are doing is to add one more condition. We want the cut to be equal to gold. So this is the condition for checking cut. And then we add our ggplot operation there. So now you can run the graph and see like the price distribution is definitely not the same as the full data set or as the data set with only carat being less than one. So you can actually look deeper into a small subset of the data by doing deplier, data manipulation, and data visualization all together. So this is a less relevant question, but it is also important for EDA. And this question, I'm going to check how many observations for each type of cut. I know we can see it by using the bar chart, but it didn't show us the exact number. So we can actually use diamonds, and then we can add the pipe, and then we can count the cut. So we can just do this, and we are getting a very nice table showing the fair cut. We have 1,610, and the ideal cut we have 21,551. So this count function is for creating a frequency table, and it is very helpful.